Hello everyone and welcome to the Talladega Super Speedway for the EA Sports 500 in the round of 12 cutoff race, our 2004 NR2003 Nextel Cup Series playoffs. As Kevin Harvick and Dale Earnhardt Jr. start on the front row as we are green and underway here from Talladega. Who will advance to the round of 8 and which 4 drivers will be eliminated having their championship hopes dashed here at Talladega? As Harvick leads down the back straightaway alongside Kurt Busch on his outside. Harvick to the advantage, trying to get another Super Speedway win. Of course, swept Daytona this season, winning the Daytona 500 and the regular season finale, the Pepsi 400 at Daytona. But with the first round exit of the playoffs after a miserable round for your defending champion. No longer defending, of course, you'll have a new champion this season. We will see as Harvick's battling Brendan Gaughan and Robbie Gordon, his teammate for the lead. Lap 1 is going to go the 31 of Robbie Gordon here at Talladega by a nose over his teammate of Kevin Harvick as the field barrels off in turn 1 and 2 on lap number 2. Trying to get all the playoff drivers jockeying for position, trying to put themselves in a great spot to advance to this next round of the playoffs, like McMurray, Mark Martin, Rusty Wallace, all three of them on the inside charging up at the top 5, all of them below the cut line coming into today. They need a good run. That's what they are doing right now. Up on the top, you got Kurt Busch, Tony Stewart also trying to be up there. Dale Jr. on lap 3. There's Ricky Rudd now leading Mark Martin into second. 3 wide for third. You got Sato Labonte, Rusty Wallace dropping back. Here comes Casey Kane up the middle making some passes. Trying to make himself an over. There's Connie in the background. There goes Jeff Burton. The 30 is spinning. Burton gets dumped by J.J. Yaley. And Burton will go crashing to the inside wall. A hard hit. No caution. Shocking because Jeff Burton gets dumped right there, but then J.J. Yaley careening right to the inside wall here, right before the entrance to pit road. A hard crash here for Jeff Burton. Bang, right to that inside wall. His car is destroyed. His competitive day is over, but he's not out of the race. But he's trying to J.J. Yaley back there. Emerging out of that wreck. We got one car spinning. That's Michael Waltrip is spinning down the front stretch. Almost looking like a old Rusty Wallace flip from back in the 90s, 80s, and 90s there, nearly. But he kept all four wheels on the ground, thank goodness. But Ryan Newman, one of our championship contenders, hooks Mikey and sends Waltrip spinning here. Coming to the start finish, so it looks like a finish of a race here. Waltrip spinning across the line and then smacking the inside wall. His bumper has significant damage, as well as Burton's does from the two incidents. So a wild start to this one here. Caution coming out for an early incident here at Talladega as Ricky Rudd, sorry, no caution came out. As Ricky Rudd, by lead the race, I now toss the L command. It's out of the restart here. Ward Burton stuffed himself in the fence here on lap 11. Big problems for the zero machine of Ward Burton as we work our way through 3 and 4. Hermie Sather going right there. There goes an 0-2. Hermie Sather, he gets turned by Yaley, slams the inside wall, flying right back into traffic. It takes out Dale Earnhardt Jr. and others. A huge crash here at Talladega, takes out the favorite, Dale Jr. Nowhere to go, just gets, drills Hermie Sather. Hermie's right up the track, right into him, takes out the 32 of Bobby Hamilton Jr. And sorry, my correction, the 11 is actually Ricky Craven. And then Dale Jarrett going around, Michael Waltrip gets involved, Casey Mears, Greg Biffle collected, Elliott Sather gets a little bit of a piece of it here. But disaster for the 8, Dale Jr. Luckily for Jr., of course, he won our last race at Charlotte Motor Speedway, clinched his spot into the round of 8, so he does not have to worry, but still a hard crash here for Dale Jr. at Talladega, knocking him out of the race. And I'll have to start from, and now let's have to focus on the round of 8 and advancing to Championship 4. And of course, more drivers crashing behind him. And a caution will come out back at the front. Your race leader is going to be scored as Robbie Gordon leading the field. And now it is Casey Kane leading the pack. Must win scenario. Kane has got to get it done here at Talladega if he wants to advance to the round of 8. And he's got to get some really good points. Comes in minus 30. He's doing just that, leading this race right now over Jeff Green in the 43 to his inside. How about Morgan Shepherd, roller skater boy, racing for Jesus, running third place right now, having a tremendous day. But Jeff Green leading the way here at Talladega over Casey Kane and Morgan Shepherd. 29 laps in. It's under chaos. We got a huge crash behind us. There was Kevin Harvick around. Cars slamming into cars. We got another pile of big hit on the outside wall there for Ward Burton and Jimmy Spencer. Sorry, Mike Wallace, that is. Kyle Petty also collected. He gets turned. Tony Stewart gets a little bit of damage, but he should be okay. Harvick spins right into Matt Kenseth. And it hits the zero of Ward Burton right up in front of the path of Mike Wallace. They both slam the outside wall hard. Caution comes out. And another wreck here at Talladega. Harvick, of course, one of the favorites. Great Super Speedway racer. 2 wins at Daytona this season. Goes around. Now going to be heavily damaged After multiple hits from cars, I mean, really the worst of it went to Ward Burton and Mike Wallace right there, slamming that outside wall hard, hard contact for those guys back at the front of the field. The race leader is going to be raced back to the line. It's going to be Jeff Green, but how about Morgan Shepherd, second place, having a legacy run right now. But it's Greenlee now on the restart. Morgan Shepherd leads us to Green at Talladega. Never thought I would say those words, but regardless, here we are. Morgan Shepherd's number 89 car in the lead versus Jeff Green here in the 43, but that lead did not last very long for Morgan Shepherd, as now it is Jeff Green back out front here at Talladega over Morgan Shepherd. Behind him, you got Jeremy Mayfield, Bobby Labonte, Scott Riggs trying to get up into the conversation for the lead and possibly the stage one win here, but so many cars are out of this race. And we've even failed to mention that the 97 of Kurt Busch, one of our championship contenders, is out of this race. He DNF'd very early on. He only came in 19 points above the cut line, so Kurt Busch definitely not safe. If things fall a certain way, Kurt Busch could be out of the playoffs here in the round of 12. And be another disappointing end to what looked like a comeback effort here in the playoffs here in this 2004 season. But Jeff Green will lead over Morgan Shepherd and Scott Riggs as we work our way into turn one and two. The back, oh, we got trouble in the back. There goes Dale Jarrett to the outside wall. Elliot Sauer, Mark Martin is destroyed. Rusty Wallace is collected. Carl Edwards has big damage. Kenseth is in it. And Rusty Wallace is barrel rolling end over end into turn two. Not like he's done that a couple of times here at Talladega before. But Jeff Gordon gets hooked by Sauer to Dale Jarrett. Jeff Gordon saves it. And Mark Martin hits the outside wall. Big hit for Mark right there. And watch as he comes down the racetrack right into Dale Jarrett. And that's what kills the six right about the Jeff Burton. And that is the straw that broke the camel's back. And Elliot Sauer absolutely lit up by Carl Edwards right there. And Sauer came in only 11 to the good above Mark Martin. So this almost seals the 6 and the 2 are out. They're both going to be out of the playoffs. I mean, this is huge. Elliot Sauer has won 4 times this season. So has Mark Martin. The winningest drivers are both about to be out in the second round of the playoffs because of this incident. I mean, this is wild. Mark Martin, Elliott Sauer, hard crash. Rusty Wallace gets taken out as well. And, of course, with that big hit from Carl Edwards at the end, officially knocks Rusty Wallace out of the race. And Rusty's playoff run will come to an end. Had to win today. Crashes out, and so he will not get the victory and not advance to the playoffs here this season out in the round of 12. Another disappointing end to a season for Rusty Wallace. Jeff Green at the front leading 3 wide with Scott Riggs. And here comes Ryan Newman coming to the last lap of the stage. This time by Newman to the lead, looking to get the stage win and the all-important playoff point to transfer himself onto the round of 8. As it looks like the 2, the 38, and the 6. There's 3 guaranteed drivers we pretty much assure you are out of the playoffs right now. We're not sure about the 30. We're sure about the 2 and the 6 being out. Maybe the 97, maybe the 38. Now we're on the last lap of stage 1. Newman in the lead, looking to bring home the stage win. 10 big time points to pretty much lock himself in that next round. It'll be his 3rd straight round of 8 appearance. And of course, the playoff point to carry on to help him out in the next round as he tries to go to his second consecutive championship 4. Behind him, you got Larry Gunselman in the 98 up here. How about Casey Kane doing exactly what he needs to do, beat up here? Jeremy Mayfield up here, Sterling Marlin, Bobby Labonte. And they're lapping the 5 of Terry Labonte. And Ryan Newman has got blockers behind him, and he has got clear track in front of him. Newman driving away here through out of turn 4, heading to the tri-oval for the final time in stage 1. Looks like it'll be another stage win for the Rocket Man as he works his way through the tri-oval. Now the straightaway for the final time, Ryan Newman wins stage 1 at Talladega. Mayfield second, Marlin, and you got Gunselman. Then you have Morgan Shepherd, your top 5. Then Bobby Labonte, Scott Riggs, Jimmy Johnson, Jeff Green, and Casey Kane, your top 10 of the stage. So big points for Kane, Johnson, and Newman. Now into stage 2. Newman still leading over by Labonte. Johnson on the outside. We got 3 wide all throughout the pack here. Working our way, coming out of turn 4 this time by on lap 62. Everyone seems to be ordered, but once again, a little bit of squeeze back there. There was a 20 of Tony Stewart gets turned around. One of our championship contenders, Stewart, gets turned by Nemechek. He slides and luckily keeps it off the wall. No damage for Stewart. He will be able to continue just fine. Regardless, yellow on the racetrack as Newman leads it out. More trouble. A big crash into turn 1. Mayfield, McMurray, Morgan Shepherd, Casey Mears, Gunselman all pile up into turn 1 at Talladega. Say McMurray got turned into Mayfield here. Mayfield, of course, already in the win, and McMurray hits Morgan Shepherd, who's running in the top five. Sends him to a hard head-on impact into the outside wall right here. Big hit for Morgan Shepherd. McMurray spins, but he should be okay. And right now he's gaining points, doing what he needs to do to try to transfer that round of eight, which would be huge for him. A big hit for Morgan Shepherd. Jeff Gordon got a piece of it, as did Stewart, but they're both fine. But Mayfield is done. Mears is done. Gunselman's done. Shepherd for sure out. Scott Wimmer probably as well. As back at the front is Scott Riggs leading Casey Kane. Now Jimmy Johnson restarts and lead over Jeff Green. And now this is lap 89. A whole bunch of cars are out of the race from a wreck that we missed. Also out of the race now are Ryan Newman in the 12 is out in 12th place. Ricky Rudd, Biffle, Harvick, Mears, Riggs, and others. It's unfortunate for Newman being out there in 12th, but he'll still advance to the next round, the round of eights. He had enough points for the stage wins today and the points coming in, so Newman will advance to his third straight round of eight appearance. Dale Jarrell has won the 88, so looks like he's going to be down to Jeff Green, Jimmy Johnson, Kyle Petty, Robbie Gordon, Tony Stewart, Jamie McMurray, Brendan Gaughan, Sterling Marlin, Casey Kane, and Bobby Labonte for the win today at Talladega. Only three playoff drivers, Johnson, Stewart, and Kane. Sorry, McMurray's the fourth one, but Kane might have the points. Same as McMurray to advance as Jeff Green leads the way now. On to the checker flag here, stage two. Jimmy Johnson wins stage two at Talladega over Casey Kane right behind him in second. Huge points there, as well as for Jamie McMurray in third. I think that'll get McMurray out of the next round. Robbie Gordon is fourth there, but he's fourth. Bobby Labonte is fifth. Kyle Petty is sixth. Here comes Tony Stewart to finish seventh and four stage points. That clinches his spot in the round of eight. Then Marlin will come home ninth in the eighth in the stage, rather. Then Brendan Gaughan has come through to finish ninth. Here he's got a long way to go. He's come to travel now. He'll be ninth, two laps down here in stage two. And Jeff Green DNFs in 10th, but will still get one stage point as Brendan Gaughan comes to take ninth in stage two, and Jimmy Johnson wins stage two at Talladega. En route to what could be a big time win here. The transfer himself in the round of eight, he's third in the year. Now here we are on the white flag. Final lap presented by Credit One Bank at Talladega for Jimmy Johnson. He leads Casey Kane by 22 seconds. The only two cars on lead lap, and the 48 is well on his way to his victory number three here in the 2004 season. Your regular season champ looking like one of the favorites to go to the championship race at Homestead. And this will easily transfer. He's already clinched on points, but he's just trying to add on to that with a win today. That'll be five more playoff points to help him out starting that round of eight. As you know, every playoff point matters, so this would be huge for Jimmy. Casey Kane in second, Jamie McMurray in third. I think they might both get enough points to transfer in. It's going to be close, but they can make an incredible comeback here at Talladega to advance us through the tri-oval for the final time. Jimmy Johnson wins at Talladega. He advances to the round of eight. Casey Kane will be your runner-up today. Jamie McMurray comes home third, a valiant effort to advance to the round of eight. Robbie Gordon fourth, Tony Stewart fifth. He will advance. Labonte sixth, Petty seventh, Marlin 8th, Gaughan 9th, and Green 10th. And here comes Casey Kane, 22 seconds behind, to finish runner-up at Talladega. And that might be enough to make the transfer and keep the rookies' championship hopes alive. This could be an incredible turn of events if he can pull it off. As you see, the final race results on the left side of your screen and the 33 DNFs that we had today, including Kurt Busch and dead last. And we'll see the updated playoff grid at the end of the round of 12 momentarily. So here's the final round of 12 standings. Johnson, Mayfield, Dale Jr. win. They advance with the four drivers eliminated. Are Rusty Wallace by 37, which we knew. Mark Martin, one of the favorites coming in, out by 14. Kurt Busch misses it by 6 with a last place finish. Heartbreak for him. He will not transfer. And Elliott Sadler, who was looking like this could be Yates' year to win the championship, had four wins, including California the last round, out by 4. His run is over, but guess whose Cinderella run continues? Casey Kane keeps on dancing. He is on the round of eight by just four. Jamie McMurray, a valiant effort to advance by 13, joining Gordon, Newman, Stewart on points, and then Junior, Mayfield, and Johnson with wins. Now, heading to the round of eight, Jimmy Johnson starts out comfortably above plus 18 points above the cut line. Best out of anybody. Then Jeremy Mayfield, Dale Jr., Ryan Newman all tied for second, plus three. Jeff Gordon out by three. Stewart and McMurray out by 11. And Kane out by 13. As the round of eight will consist of Atlanta, Las Vegas, and Martinsville. So until the next episode, for our second Atlanta race on the season, the round of eight opener, I hope you all have a good one.